DJI just released a huge update for the Air 3 and the Mini 4 Pro that bring brand new features like vision assist and being able to turn off the downward obstacle avoidance, plus some new photo features and active track features, but also it brings in compatibility with the Goggles 2 and the motion controller if you like flying with those. Let's go outside and check out some of these new features. So I want to show you how vision assist works and how also turning off the downward sensors will work so you can get different kinds of shots. Now, vision assist is basically they're allowing us to look through the obstacle avoidance cameras, which is super useful if you're flying near to objects or maybe flying in areas where you still have a good line of sight, because you should always be safe and still have a good line of sight. But you want to know and keep an eye on like how close you're getting to something, like if you're panning or moving sideways, and you want to kind of keep an eye on how close you're getting to something, and your line of sight direct may not give you a good visual of how of depth perception. So let's take this off and we'll see exactly. So this is something you get where you can decide if you want it to right on takeoff. On that little warning, I only turn it off and on when I know I want it to be turned off and on, because I don't want to forget that I accidentally turned it off and then come into land and smash my drone into the ground. So first, to enable or to get into vision assist, you swipe sideways on the map icon there. And now you can see your different angles. You can go forward, look at sideways, look at behind or the other sideways, look forward, and then you get this nice yellow box when there are obstacles nearby. Now I'm fairly close to the drone, so obviously there are obstacles nearby, but you'll notice that it's working even though obstacle avoidance is off. It's showing a yellow screen. Now the cool thing is too, you can actually maximize this and be able to look at this full screen while you're flying. So if I was to go sideways, I can keep an eye on the drone. I can keep an eye on what I'm filming, but also I can keep an eye on what's looking out at the side. Now it's not great, but it is enough to give you an idea of what's coming up. And as you get closer to something, obviously it'll start to give you a warning and then you can stop. Now again, this doesn't replace visual line of sight, at least here in the United States. And I think in most places you are required to maintain visual line of sight with the drone, which means you should be able to look at the controller, look up the drone and be able to find it in the sky and get basic information like attitude, which direction it's going, facing, all of that sort of stuff. But it does add an extra level of safety if you're flying near objects or nearby obstacles and you want to just keep an eye open to the side while you're flying. It does give you more ability to be safe in environments where you're going to be close to obstacles. Now, another thing that DJI added in this firmware update is the ability to turn visual positioning and obstacle avoidance, downward obstacle avoidance, off. Now, that means a couple of things. Is that now you can land without it coming down and pausing about 18 inches or half a meter above the ground and then slowly descending, which is massive if you're operating from moving objects like a boat, where you need to come down and bring the drone down quickly so you can grab it by hand or get it on the deck while the boat is moving up and down, which will really throw off how a drone is landing. It makes it very difficult to land a drone in a boat. But now that you can turn that off, it means you're not gonna have that issue. But it also means the drone is not gonna hold its position steady or stable in one area. It might drift around because it's solely relying on GPS position now. The other thing it means is that you can fly really low to stuff and get really, really low to the ground shots without the drone suddenly going into a landing mode, which I love because I love flying low to stuff. I'll demonstrate what this does in a second, but here's how you get to it. Tap on the three little bits, you are in the safety tab, go all the way to the bottom, advanced safety settings, all the way down, and turn off visual positioning. You'll get a warning, say okay, and then you can do this. Now, watch what happens when I bring the drone in to land it. It descends straight down into my hand. We'll turn it back on and I'll show you what it does when it's on. All right, so now I've turned it back on. We're gonna bring it in and do the same thing. So I'm holding the stick down, but then it enters that landing mode. Super useful if you're gonna work from moving objects or things that aren't as stable as solid ground, boats, something on the water for sure. Any moving vehicles, this is a super useful mode for. So now obviously this means you can get super low to stuff, super low to the ground and get some very cool low shots. But also it means the drone will definitely run into the ground if you're not extremely careful and keeping an eye, because normally the drone would climb with terrain as it comes in because it wants to keep that 18 inch distance. It won't do that anymore.
Hey, if you're enjoying or getting any value out of this video, then consider subscribing. My goal is to help solo creators like myself make good decisions when it comes to buying gear and teach you skills to use that gear to its fullest potential.
Now they've also given us some other options in Active Track. So let me show you what I mean. Well, Active Track myself here. You can hit Active Track, you can hit Auto and Go, which then the drone will kind of just decide what it needs to do based on what's happening in the scene. So right now it thinks it should follow me because it thinks I'm probably walking. But if we wait for a second, it'll switch and decide, oh, I need to do something around where I'm moving around the subject. But then if you just hit Active Track Trace and Go, this is where you can draw lines and have the drone do certain things that you want it to do. Just like you could with the Mini 4, which is fantastic because I love that way of being able to do things with the Mini 4 and have it sort of circle around, make movements without you having to do as much. And the drone is able to just get footage of you moving around like you did with the Mini 4. It's one of my favorite features they've added for a long time in DJI's Active Track. Now, while most of these features have been added to the Mini 4 Pro and the Air 3, there's a couple of things that are exclusive to the Air 3. And one is that you can do the Active Track auto mode in both cameras. So I'll switch to the 3X camera here. We're gonna try and Active Track myself. There we go, we can go Active Track, go. And again, same thing. You can kind of do that sort of, you know, cool Active Track motions with the 3X camera, which I love the 3X camera. But you can also do auto if you want to. So we'll let it sit here and see what it does. I think pretty much it just switches between follow and helix mode every now and then, depending on what's going on in the scene, just to kind of give you some options and motion, which I think honestly is very cool.
Now also in this firmware update comes support for the Goggles 2 and the motion controller. I don't have the motion controller, so I can't try it out. And I can't fly the drone with the Goggles 2 because essentially to be able to use the Goggles 2 and fly the drone, you also have to have the motion controller. But I will say I did link the Goggles 2 to both drones and it did work. I could see out the main camera through the goggles, which is pretty cool. I hope DJI adds support for being able to use the Goggles 2 as your main screen, but still be able to fly with the standard or the regular remotes. I think that would be pretty amazing.
And another thing that's been added to the Air 3 is now in photo mode, you can digitally zoom in. Now, obviously, I wouldn't recommend doing this because you do lose resolution, but if you were looking to just get a little bit extra punch, or say you wanna switch to the 3X lens, we'll go all the way into 9X, which is 216 millimeters. That seems insane to me, but it is kind of cool. And one more thing they added to the Air 3 is now you can do 360 panoramas in the 3X camera mode, which I think is fantastic. So it's gonna take 137 images and then stitch those together in a super high resolution 360 panorama with the 3X camera. So cool.
I think by far my favorite new features are the vision assist modes and the ability to turn off downward obstacle avoidance because I operate from moving vehicles a lot and I love to get those low down to the ground shots. Next, you're gonna wanna watch this video right here. I'll see you over there. As always, if you have questions, ask me in the comments below or you can join my live stream, which happens most Wednesday nights at 4 p.m. Alaska time, 8 p.m. Eastern, where we can have more of a conversation and I can answer questions maybe I didn't get to this video. I will see you again soon in the next video. Cheers.